Hey guys, so today we're going to be replacing a serpentine bolt on a Ford Transit. These are the tools you require. You need a power bar. I'm using a half inch, so I've got an adapter, a 3/8 adapter, because you need a 3/8 power bar or adapter or something similar to fit into the tensioner over there. Okay, so you need that. You'll need an extension. You'll need a T40 bit to remove this top plastic cover, and obviously a ratchet of some sort. So to remove this top plastic cover, there's three bolts, one here, one there, that side, and another one over there. So there, there, and there. So remove those three bolts, and then you gently lift this wiring loom out, and you pull this cover off. You want to pull it from this end and gently pull the loom out and just keep this way. Now you want to come in here and go to your tensioner. So that's your tensioner there. That's your tensioner. You want to take your 3/8 adapter or power bar. You want to slot it in there like so. And just gently pull back. That releases the tension. Don't know if you can see that. Do you take note of how the belt routes under the pulleys and the water pump and the vacuum pump and all the accessories? So when you want to take it off, you come to this pulley here. You just slide it off here. You know, you can gently release the tensioner. You can choose to leave the tensioner. You can choose to leave the power bar within the tensioner if you're going to replace it straight away. If not, just take it out for safety. That's how you take out the serpentine belt on a Ford Transit. Okay, so now I'll show you how to install the new belt. So what you want to do is, with the belt, you want to form a loop like that and start at the alternator. I personally like to start at the alternator. You don't have to, but then you want to wrap it over this tensioner, run it down to the main crankshaft pulley. You want to wrap it like that, around the main crankshaft pulley. You want to bring it up here to the power steering pump. Twist the belt right here. Put it over your vacuum pump and your water pump if you can. This one's a bit too tight, so what I'll have to do is now use the power bar. Put it right in the tensioner and pull back on it to release the tension. Now you can put it over the water pump and the vacuum pump, and you slip it under the idler pulley here. You can also inspect this idler pulley at that time. Just check for any excessive play or noisy bearing. This one's okay. Just push it in like that. Make sure everything is aligned with all the pulleys, and if all is fine, then you can release the tensioner and test your new belt up. your cover back in after you test your belt. So to put your cover in, tilt it like this, and you can slot your loom into this plastic bit here. Just slot it like so. That's it, and you just put your three bolts there, there, and there. Tighten it up, and you're good to go from there.
Alright, thanks for watching, guys. Be sure to like and subscribe, it really helps. And also, leave any comments in the comment box below if you need any help or any questions, if you have any questions. Alright, thanks for watching.